to My Rotary. My name is Jamie Mick, and I'm past district governor for District 6950, and I'm your host today. Today, we wanted to talk a little bit about Rotary's birthday. Happy birthday, Rotary! We wanted to tell you a little bit about how clubs across the U.S. and other countries celebrated Rotary. And I think we're showing a couple pictures of those now. Some folks in Australia, as well as some folks right here in the United States. And my question to you is, how did you celebrate Rotary's birthday? What did your club do? I know what mine did. We actually had the privilege of meeting on Tuesday. We meet every Tuesday, and we actually had a birthday cake. So that was our dessert for our lunch that day. But I wanted to show you some of those photographs so you could think about maybe next year and how your club might be able to publicize the birth date of Rotary in your community, because I'm sure that you've made an impact just as we have. Some of the news in Rotary International that came up when I was doing a little bit of research was about eBay. Now, Wayne, you had talked about it. eBay is doing live auctions, just like at Christie's and all over those live auction places all over the country. And now you're able to participate. You can stay right there at your house or at your desk and use your mouse and go ahead and bid on auction items right on eBay. And the part of the proceeds go to help us with our humanitarian efforts.
Yep, that's a great thing.
And there are, from what I could see, there are dozens of auctions every day. And this is a new partnership that just kicked off in January with eBay. I don't know about you guys, but I do a lot of shopping on eBay. I don't have time to go out anymore and do the traditional mall shopping. So a lot of the dance dresses and stuff for Rotary, I find it right on eBay. And it comes right to the door. So now I'm going to check out the auctions to see what else they've got. They actually mentioned some memorabilia for Star Wars and Elvis and some of the other trend-setting things that a lot of folks that like to go to auctions look for. So I'm going to certainly check it out. I think we have a picture of some folks from eBay from the main office there that are kind of celebrating this partnership with Rotary. The other thing that I found interesting, of course, I'm from Michigan. I'm from the Upper Peninsula of Michigan. My mom was born in Bay City. And I'm sure you all heard about the Flint water crisis in Michigan, where they changed their water from the Huron River, which is what they call Detroit water, to the Flint River. And what they didn't really think about or really know how to deal with was the pipes. And apparently the pipes have then shed lead into that water system, and it's created a huge emergency there. And so, of course, Rotary is there. The clubs in Flint and the surrounding areas are coming together. There are fire stations and churches and community partners that are giving out water as well as water filters. So those folks can attach those water filters at their homes and filter that water and hopefully get the lead out of it. There are also a couple other things. If you're interested in donating to the Flint water crisis, www.flintrotary.org is the website. Now, if you go on their website and kind of scroll down towards the bottom, there's a huge reprint of the article that I read. You click on the donate button and you're able to donate to the cause. The other thing is that they also have a button there that you can donate to the Flint Child Health and Development Fund. Now, these folks are actually helping to prevent some of the lead poisoning that's going on with medication, and really starting to look at providing them with a long-term solution, because they have about 8,656 children under the age of 6 in that community that have been exposed to this basically bad water, and there's going to be health issues in the future. So they want to figure out how to deal with that. And of course, the Rotary Club there, I think there's two or three in the Flint area, and they are actually partnering with them to figure out what these folks need and how Rotary can make an impact, which I thought was huge, because Rotary's always kind of there. When we had hurricanes in our community back in 2004, Rotary was there dishing out ice, doing all sorts of things to try to help hurricane victims. This is not a whole lot different, except the ramifications from this emergency are going to be long-running. And so they're really preparing to partner with those community leaders. The other article that I found on Rotary.org that I thought was really relevant was talking about membership. Now, all of you have recruited somebody to your club and asked them to become a Rotarian, or you were recruited, asked to become a Rotarian. And one of the things that this article talked about was really about making it personal, telling your Rotary story. Why did you seek out Rotary? Why is it that you are still a Rotarian, which is a question I'll ask you later. But in this article, they really talk about make it personal. Find out from that person what is their interest in Rotary, what's personally driving them to become a Rotarian. Because by doing that, we're able to really show them how our club, or maybe another club, and I always tell folks, you know, we have 6 Rotary clubs in a 5-mile area from where we're sitting right now. I would love you to join my club, but if you don't join my club, join a Rotary club and become part of Rotary. So every club's a little bit different. But they all specifically talked about young professionals. And I didn't really think about this, but you know, young professionals, particularly those folks in their 20s and 30s, they like to personalize everything. Think about their iPhones and their tablets. They personalize everything, including the way that they socialize. So you need to be able to be flexible and help them to personalize Rotary so that they're able to really make that connection with your club. The other thing is you may have a long-standing community leader that you want to become a Rotarian, but they're stretched in time. They can't always find the time. They say, there's never enough time. I'm trying to build my business. I just don't have time for Rotary. Well, talking to them a little bit about, you know, when you need to get something done, whether it's at your business or it's at your home, who do you call? Who do you think of first? I don't know about you guys, but I think of a Rotarian. I mean, when I have an AC issue, I'm calling Gil. You know, if I had personal injury issue, which thank goodness I haven't, I would call Duran and Bean. I mean, that's what I would do. But why? A, I know you guys. How do I know you? I know you from Rotary. So it really can help somebody with their marketing and save time because they're doing service while they're building their business. So if they kind of point that out to them, they might be a little bit more inclined to make the time. And then, of course, once they fall in love with Rotary, it won't be a problem because they'll want to be there. They'll want to serve. And then you've got some of those folks that have new families, that have children. Time is really hard for them to make time to come to a regular monthly meeting. So thinking about, and I don't know how you guys do it, but in our club, if you participate in a service project or you participate in a training at the district level, that's your makeup. So that week you wouldn't have to come to the club meeting if you had to do something else, like take a sick child to the doctors or go to a soccer game or something like that. So being flexible. Also making sure that whatever their needs might be, that you kind of show them how Rotary can really help them, you know, fill those needs. I always think about the folks that started Polio. You know, when you think about it, it was a group of people. One of them was a drug rep who thought we could immunize a few kids and see if we could prevent, you know, polio. And then it blossomed into an international initiative that we've done for now, you know, almost 30 years. So I think it's important to really think about, there's no crazy idea. If someone has a passion to serve, then Rotary certainly can be able to help them find that way. The other one is, I always think of Shelterbox. Started out as a club project, and now here it is, you know, those shots, I'll never forget the shots on television of all those tents when they were showing it on the news, and I thought, yep, there's all those tents, and they all have Rotary wheels on them, because they all came from Shelterbox. Started in a club in England, and now here we are, an international initiative that we all support. So some of the good news that's coming from Rotary. Some of the other things that I thought were kind of interesting, of course, is this February was all about the Peace Centers. Peace and Conflict Resolution was February's theme. And so there were several peace summits, one in Africa, one in Australia. And the Peace Summits is where they bring community leaders together and Rotarian leaders together. And they basically talk about working out conflict, which I always think is something that we always here in the U.S., we don't really think about much because we live in such, we're so blessed in the way that we live our lives here that we don't think about those. But a lot of folks live in areas where, you know, conflict is a constant daily struggle for them to really be able to just exist. And this is a way for us as a community, as leaders in the world, to come together and try to work some of those things out. And we've had a couple of peace scholars that have come here from Pasco, and we had one that recently came from the Pinellas area that we sponsored. And those folks come back from time to time and tell us about their studies. And we saw some of those at PETS, didn't we, Gil, when we went last year? I think we had the young man.
Yes.
He was there. And they're always, you know, it's always amazing to watch. They go in as these young adults, very scared, not quite sure, and they come out, and he was a phenomenal speaker, really able to talk about, you know, resolving conflict and how he was able to witness that in several countries across the world. So February is a big month for us because of the birth date of Rotary, but also because of the peace and conflict. And I think that that's become a larger initiative for every Rotary International president as they've gone along. So we've got a little time left in this first segment, so why don't we talk a little bit about Divas and Diamonds, which was a great fundraiser. I was there on Saturday night. Robin, tell us a little bit about how it got started.
Divas and Diamonds originated with Tina Farrell. Tina was running for the honorary governorship of West Pasco Chamber. She needed a signature fundraising event to promote her governorship, and we came together with this idea of a ladies-only event. From that point on, she brought it to the Port Richey Rotary Club and thought that it would be a great event to step up the new year. So we did the event in February, and we coincided with the Newport Richey Rotary Club's event, so that that particular night the gentlemen will go to their event, which is a gentleman's only event, and the ladies could then come to our event. And we are completely diverse in what we offer, but the idea is the same, that it would just different Rotarians coming together. And the event has, I believe, made a mark. And this year was a great event. We had about 150 ladies as our guests, and they are wined and dined, and they are allowed to go shopping.
Yes.
We have been very fortunate that the original 10 bar vendor sponsorships almost unilaterally have repeated. So it takes us about 3 to 4 days to lock in the bar sponsorships, and those bars are individualized ladies-only drinks. So we had a chocolate martini, Cosmopolitan bar. This year we added Moscow Mule. We actually even have a separate bar for just beer, because there's a lot of our ladies enjoy a glass of beer. Each lady is treated very special. They get a glass when they walk in the door, and the glass changes colors. So as they walk into the event venue, it's a little dark, and they turn their glasses on, and they can go to whatever bar they want to and have samples of a particular drink, or they can fill their glass up and just enjoy that particular drink. We also coordinated with vendors, and those vendors are ladies designer type vendors. We have different jewelers from the area, some with real jewelry, some with costume. We've added other types of vendors that are particular to ladies' needs. And all in all, this year we had 16 vendors. And it's nice for us because the vendors pay for their spot. The bar sponsors pay for their spot. We have other sponsors that came on board, and we have a waiting list for next year.
Oh, that's awesome. That's terrific. And it's a great event because it's just a real fun girls' night out where you feel very special when the minute you walk in the door. Everybody greets you, and you get your ride in the golf cart from your car, which I thought was a great touch, because it is a little difficult in those heels sometimes to maneuver that parking lot. So that worked out really well. We're going to go to a commercial break, but we're going to talk more about it when we get back.
Okay.
So we've got a few commercial breaks for you, a little public service announcement from Rotary, and we'll see you in a little bit.
This is one bee that loves going to the dentist because it's made for you and me.
My name is Dr. Bezerra from New Tampa Pediatric Dental, providing a comfortable atmosphere in early dental care. Gives kids a great start for healthy teeth and gums for life.
My middle son did not like to come to the dentist, but now he loves to come to the Beehive.
You don't have to be afraid to go to the dentist.
Believe me, Dr. B and his worker bees are the best. Call New Tampa Pediatric Dental today.
Revolutionary in his field, Dr. Bonatti created, perfected, and patented the Bonatti spine procedures. Using his genius, Bonatti invented precise tools necessary to minimize surgery, scarring, anesthesia, and recovery. So successful are the Bonatti spine procedures, they consistently reflect over 94% patient satisfaction. 45,000 successful procedures have been performed exclusively at our location. Nearly half our patients suffer from failed back and neck surgeries at other facilities. Bonatti succeeds where others fail.
We'll be right back. young professionals and young people can find something in Rotary that makes so much sense for their existence.
One of my goals, and I think one of the goals of just younger people in general as we get into organizations like this, is to kind of diversify it.
There are a lot of people who have, you know, have a lot to offer, but don't know an outlet for it, don't know where to put it, and this gives you access to everything.
I was just amazed at everything Rotary did and how much bigger than it was than what I thought it was, and so I wanted to join. I wanted to be a part of that.
You know, we laugh. It's a bunch of old guys that get together for lunch every week, and it's the furthest thing from that.
It's so much more than I originally thought it was. It wasn't just about making friends. It was about going out on a random Friday morning and helping to build a barn.
You know, we tend to be a little compartmentalized in our lives, and sometimes we forget people in our community who need help.
The face-to-face, the personal engagement with individuals and in the community, is you can't find that or replicate that elsewhere.
Whether we come from one walk of life or another, it transcends all of that because we come together in the name of service.
As a young professional, I just think it's one of the best things I could possibly have done.
Welcome back. Now, Robin and I were talking a little bit about Divas and Diamonds, which, again, I love that event. I actually brought some ladies with me from the dance studio. They're a little older than I am, but they had a ball.
That's great.
They tried every drink, I think. I was a little worried about them when they were trying every single one. But you really had a diverse group of folks there. It wasn't the same, you know, it wasn't just a bunch of Rotarians.
That is correct.
There were definitely folks from the community that, quite honestly, Robin, I'd never seen. We go to a lot of stuff.
Yeah. We were fortunate. Friends of friends, people who had attended the year before, mm-hmm. Brought some new people in, and they were quite amazed. So their husbands were not Rotarians, but yet they were invited to the event, and a lot of them have actually posted on Facebook they had so much fun, they're going to bring their friends next year.
Yep.
And I think that's just how the word will spread.
Yeah, I think that it'll grow exponentially
next year,
which would be a great thing. And you had a great DJ, which at the end, when he brought all the bartenders out, which is always the fun time.
Yes.
And it's Raining Men's plays. And I wish I videotaped everything, and I just couldn't get it to download. But I always, you know, the girls thought that was great. Maria and Ida just were like, what is going on? I said, well, you got to see this. Come see this. Everybody just had good fun. It was really great. You had a photo booth there.
We had a photo booth, and one of the things that we do that's a little unique is that we allow our vendors to put into our donation table gift certificates to their businesses.
Mm-hmm.
So, and we give those away for free. We don't charge for those. So every lady walks out with a gift certificate to some place that they've never been exposed to before. And it might be an AC and heating company. It might be a financial advisor.
Mm-hmm.
People who have want to represent their companies, but they really don't know how. And we allow them to, like, attach their gift certificate to a bottle of wine or a little personalized basket. And so each lady feels special because they leave with a free gift to do something else.
Right. And I remember the girls were asking me, they said, you know, the first bartender we went up to, they were going to pay him. I said, no. You just give them your glass. This is part of the deal. This is part of your ticket price.
Exactly.
So they expected, to be paying for those things. And then you had the chance to win a diamond, which was very big, with your flute of champagne.
Our first time doing that.
That was good.
It was successful, yes. And
yeah.
We actually had a winner.
No, that's good. And it's good. I was convinced I had it. I was thoroughly convinced I was the one with the diamond, but it wasn't. But it's still a beautiful zirconi that I have in my bracelet that I bought there that night. But the ladies thought that was really cool as well. And then you had 50-50. Which is a standby that we all kind of have at our fundraisers.
We try to keep the purchasing to a minimum,
mm-hmm.
because our goal is to have you enjoy your evening. You've already paid for your ticket, for your drinks and your dinner. It's more about enjoying the atmosphere, getting away from everything, shopping, meeting new vendors in our local community. Everyone that came there is from the local area. They had a little chance to expose their business and what they do. And that's the main premise, although we like to raise money.
Sure.
And through the ticket sales and the vendor sponsorships, we were able to do so.
And then how? What do you do with the money that are from the proceeds of the event?
That is a decision made through the Rotary Board for the Port Richey Rotary. Each year that they take and allocate so much money from that particular event, and they give it back to the local charities in our area. That's the nicest part about this event, is that all the money we raise goes right back into our community.
Yeah, and I think I've been to those club meetings where you dish out that money, and been the proud recipient on behalf of the Rotary's Camp Florida to receive a check there. So it's really nice that you guys give all that money back to the community. And again, that's kind of what it's all about, is for us
exactly.
to have an opportunity to give back. Now, Wayne, you've got another event coming in just a couple weeks, the End Polio Now Breakfast.
Right.
Matter Tell
of
us
fact,
about
it's
that.
It's this Friday, this Saturday.
Oh, yes, it is.
On March the 5th.
How time
jumped
flies.
Up on us here quick. And it's an End Polio Now Breakfast. It's our second annual End Polio Now Breakfast event, and it starts at 8 o'clock Saturday morning, early Saturday morning, goes to 11, so it doesn't mess up the whole day.
Oh, that's good.
We involve our Interact Club as servers. We involve the rest of the Rotary Club members as cooks, and we just have a grand old time. And the funds that we raise from this go back to End Polio Now. So if we raise $2,000, it ends up being $6,000 with the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation match.
Correct.
So
correct.
How can you go wrong with that?
Exactly. Now tell us how it got started.
Got started a couple years ago when we decided, the club decided, you know, we really want to do something special for End Polio Now. Our club had not done something very special for it. We participated in district events and things of that nature. But the board decided, let's do something club-wise, specifically for End Polio Now. And that's how we got it started. So this will be our second year, and we just have a wonderful time. Tickets are, each individual member of our club sells tickets. Their tickets are $8 a piece. There will be some tickets available at the door.
Mm-hmm.
And it's held at King of Kings Lutheran Church, right there just south of Jasmine Boulevard on US 19. So invite everybody to come out, have a great time with us for a couple or 3 hours.
Oh, that's good. And you have the great honor of having Rob and his mom. Rob's a longstanding member of your club.
Yes, he is.
And Mama Aegis, who's a pretty good cook, as I understand.
Yes, she is a great cook.
And so I'm sure she helps with the pancakes and
she
everything.
Does.
Yeah, because she's really great. And those folks over at Marchman are always so supportive of everything we do in Rotary,
right?
Whether it be your club or anyone else's, but Rob and his mom are always very supportive. And I think if I'm correct, we have a couple of photographs of last year.
Yes.
With your End Polio Now aprons on and everything, and your Interact kids there as well. And I think that you know, we're very fortunate in District 6950 because we kind of really understand you know, where the End Polio Now came from because of Herb Brown and his travels, and when he was president-elect of Rotary International, and you know that he really kind of embraced this project as an international initiative, and through that we've been able to partner with the World Health Organization and the CDC.
It's amazing.
Yes.
It's amazing what Rotary's done to End Polio Now. When we started out with this program back in the middle 80s, the program, there was 350,000 children, babies, that had polio. Today, I just saw a statistic just before I left the home that there's two countries left
mm-hmm.
That are endemic with polio, and very, very, very few, 40 children. Think about that, 350,000.
Yep.
Now there's 40 because Rotary took action.
That's right. And I think it's important that, you know, right now we have one case that's been identified since the first of the year, since January 1st. And, you know, without folks like Bill and Melinda Gates partnering with us, it would have been difficult to really make the final push.
Right.
We've been working on it for as an organization for quite a long time. But we are certainly recognized for really, you know, getting the job done, staying in it.
This close.
We certainly are. And at the commercial break, you'll see some commercial PSA, public service announcements, of some of the folks and the folks that you'll recognize, you know, Hollywood personalities that are now endorsing and helping us with the public image of End Polio Now, which I think is just so beautiful to watch them really start to care about, making a difference in the world and also serving their community. So even those folks making the movies that we honored last night, they want to make a difference too, and a lot of them have joined us in this fight to end polio. And I think that we will actually see the end of polio, and we'll have rid the world of a horrific disease. And we have several polio survivors in our district that we've all met.
Yeah.
I always think of Warren Rogers, who's just a remarkable man, and certainly lived his life with polio, but yet just unbelievable. Unbelievable in the progress that he's
so
made.
So come out Saturday morning, 8 o'clock. Be with us.
I would if I could, but you know where I'll be.
I do know where you'll be, and we tried desperately not to have that event conflict.
It's very difficult, but I'll be there in spirit, Wayne.
I got you.
And you can eat my pancakes, because I wouldn't eat the pancakes
anyway.
We're going to go to a commercial break. When we get back, we're going to talk about the Port Richey Rotary Club and what makes them unique. So take a look at these commercials. We'll be right back.
Beltran Dental Surgery is dedicated to providing the highest quality dental surgery.
Teeth in a Day allows a patient to walk in with their old teeth, sleep under IV sedation, and walk out with a brand new smile. Unlike dentures, Teeth in a Day allows you to eat what you want and still feel like you have your own teeth.
From wisdom teeth removal to implants or creating a whole new smile, call now or visit our website to learn more about our procedures. Get a brand new smile today.
This is one bee that loves going to the dentist because it's made for you and me.
Providing a comfortable atmosphere in early dental care gives kids a great start for healthy teeth and gums for life.
Coming here, you're not just like an ordinary patient. You're actually like treated like a family member, and like you're treated like he actually gets to know you and makes you smile.
Welcome to New Tampa Pediatric Dental, and we are the
Bees!
Call New Tampa Pediatric Dental today.
Everyone's story is different, so why be limited to just one or two options? With Norcom's Norflex Home Loan, you're given the flexibility to tell your story. Pick your terms from 8 to 30 years, all while maintaining a low, fixed mortgage rate. You can pay off your loan more quickly or choose a term based on your budget and timeline. Whatever you do with the Norflex Home Loan, make it part of your financial plan. Norflex. Short term, long term, your terms. Apply online at norcommortgage.com.
Welcome back. We're going to talk a little bit about the Rotary Club of Port Richey. Gil McWilliams is the current president, and he's got his presidential hat on, which I happened to be with him at Downtown Disney when he purchased that. You've worn it all year, haven't you? It's kind of your signature, your trademark. So what's it like being president?
President at first is a little scary, you know, taking on a commitment. But as I got into it, I realized that, you know, it's a leadership skill, and it actually helps me out in my personal life or my business too. So when I'm out there, you know, I'm meeting, greeting, and it helps me deal with other people, get out in front, or I would never normally even be here talking in front of everybody because it's not my thing.
You're kind of shy when we first started out, when we were at President-elect training about a year ago.
Yeah.
You're pretty shy about things. Now you're out there, and I came to a club meeting recently, and you were just moving and grooving like it was no problem at all.
Yeah, Rotary's been an eye-opener. You know, I was doing a lot of Rotarian things out there, and, you know, with the leadership they have as far as training and stuff like that, it enables you to focus on and hone on your own skills in the real world. So it's actually, you know, and just to be a member, they give it to you free among other leaders and business leaders out there, you know, across the country. They bring them into a little group, and you all get to learn on how they do business. And it's like, I mean, I didn't even have to go to college for that, you know, so we're good.
We put you through our own mini little Rotary College, is what we put you through. In fact, we have that coming up. We're going to talk about that at the district level. So tell me, where do you guys meet? When do you meet? I mean, I know where you are, but let's tell the folks, you know.
We meet at Carrabba's at 12 noon on Fridays for lunch downtown in Port Richey, Florida. And, you know, it's a nice restaurant to have food and fellowship. Mm-hmm. Out there, it's like our club, I guess, you know, some of the things that stand out about is, you know, Interact, I guess
you'd say.
Oh,
we do a lot with Interact.
I think we're probably one of the bigger Interact clubs out there, and we have a lot of members that come back to the community that help support it.
Yeah, and I think we have a picture of you guys with your Interact club. And you do a pretty unique program. Do it once a month or once a quarter?
Yeah, once a quarter we do a program. It's we pick a topic, and then the kids come in out of school, and they bring a topic. Last one was about minimum wage being raised, because they're talking about how many families have to get 2 and 3 jobs, and a lot of people without certain education out there are still stuck in a minimum wage basis, and they got to work 3 jobs, and they still can't make ends meet. So that was a pretty heated topic there.
And how do you guys pick those topics? Do you as a club pick them, or do the Interact kids pick them?
We toss ideas out there, and sometimes they'll bring it up, or we normally try to bring a topic up for them. The other thing we do once a year out of the fourth quarter, we actually have an OJT. The business people in our club will actually take them out. I've done it myself, drive out with us in our regular everyday business life as far as going to the office, you know, going.
So they shadow you.
They shadow us, and then we take them out, and then we bring them back to lunch for 4 hours, and then they discuss what they learn and maybe help, you know, help them decide that they don't want to do AC and crime and addicts. So.
Yeah, not everybody's cut out to do that. I'm a little claustrophobic. But that's a real vocation. I mean, lots of folks often ask, you know, how does your club serve vocational? What does that really mean, vocational service? But, I mean, that's a perfect example of how a club can really practice vocational service with the youth, because, you know, shadowing somebody, you know, remember way back, it was quite a while back, thinking about what you wanted to do for a living, you know. I was going to be a park ranger, you know. So, and then one thing led to another, and now what am I, a commercial real estate broker? So a little bit different, not certainly the avenue I thought, but if I'd have been able to shadow somebody, I might have been able to really see what life was like and not just what I dreamed it to be.
Yeah, I'm glad you said that, because, you know, we host exchange students even in my household too, in our club, and, you know, being there, sometimes you see kids start making different changes about their future. And I like to feel like I had a part in that. And, you know, with these other kids hearing about the minimum wage, I'm the owner of a company, so I employ people. And it's like sometimes I have to question it. You know, I actually went back and gave a couple guys a raise because I know they needed just a little bit more. And surprisingly enough, they actually gave me more than what I gave them as far as work ethics. And I was able to grow a better morale within the guys and all that to work out there. So
you learned from them.
I learned from them, too.
Yeah. And I think that's a great thing, you know, it kind of makes us stop and think a little bit about the path we're on and how those small decisions affect the people around us. And I always enjoy coming to your club when the Interact kids are there and you're doing that, because I've been there through some pretty heated conversations. I remember talking about panhandlers, and Dr. Musumira was in the room, and that was a very interesting conversation because they had no idea who he was. So they certainly just told them the way that they felt, which I think is great, because young folks have such a different way of looking at it than we do. It's been a different journey for them. They've just got a different view through the looking glass.
Well, it hasn't been as long for them. And so they have fresh eyes
right.
that they're looking at things. And Jamie, I just wanted to mention one thing, that our club has been in existence since March the 2nd, 1981.
Wow.
So we have a birthday coming up here shortly. And one of our founding directors is still with the club, Mike Stone.
And
we call him the Godfather.
That's correct.
Because he has been there since day one. And we certainly do appreciate Mike and his influence and his help along the way for these many, many years.
Yeah.
So March the 2nd, 1981, yay.
Wow. So Friday you should have a birthday party.
35 years.
For sure, yeah. That's a long time.
It is.
That's a long time. And think of the impact that you've made in the area. It's huge. You know, on the break we were talking about, you know, we have six clubs in this area on the west side of Pasco. And, you know, someone was asking, well, how many Rotarians? And so for 300 Rotarians and this community, and I know we all sit on different boards. And when I sit on those boards, and I kind of always kind of take account, you know, as I'm sitting there, because usually 80 to 90% of the board is made up of Rotarians from other clubs. So Rotary really does make a huge impact in our immediate community and certainly within our county. And Wayne and I have had the honor of working with all the clubs, and we've done a lot of unique things together as six clubs together that have come together. And this just in about, 10 days, you're going to be supporting Raise the Roof. All six clubs have stepped up to the plate, so that'll be a great event and great exposure for the six of you to really talk, really make an impact on these folks that were affected by that rain event that we had in July and August. And that's the kind of thing that makes Rotary unique, I think, is that we all try to work together to make the community a better place.
Yep. Service above self.
Exactly. And, you know, I always want to ask, who is the, you know, everyone says, well, what kind of member are you looking for, you know? And I always hate it when they say anybody that can fog the glass, because that's not, you know, that's really not what we're looking for. Talk about who you think, you know, who's the perfect candidate for membership in your club?
You have to talk with people, business people in the area, and kind of pick out the ones that have the same ethical ideas that you do and can pass those along. If you don't have the same ethical feelings that I do about business or about customers, I'm not so sure I want you in my Rotary Club.
Right. Because you're eating lunch together every Friday.
That's right.
And you're working and sweating next to each other, working in the community. So you want to make sure you have like-minded folks.
Absolutely.
That are interested in serving. But, you know, I always ask, you know, why did you join Rotary? I mean, I know for myself, it was really because I wanted to give back, but I didn't know how to do that. And so I thought, well, Rotary, because I had been an exchange student, was, you know, something very effective in the community I grew up in. So I should probably go and check out a Rotary Club. And I happened to be in a networking group with Robin's husband, Steve, and said, can I come to your Rotary Club and see what it's like? You know, because I'd not been to a Rotary meeting in quite a long time. And sure enough, there, you know, I came. Now, someone else sponsored me. It wasn't Steve, but you know, we've worked together in the Holiday Rotary Club for years. But it's really, for me now, really about trying to, you know, really making a difference in the world, trying to make a positive impact to the people around me. How about you, Robin? You're a pretty new Rotarian.
I'm a really new Rotarian to Port Richey.
Yeah.
But I am a senior citizen at the Holiday
Rotary Club. Yes, you are.
Because through my husband, Steve Duran, I actually worked almost every event.
Yes.
With Steve for 18 years.
Mm-hmm.
So in that respect, I was sort of a veteran of what's expected from a Rotarian. Truly did not have an aspiration to be a Rotarian because I was already serving a different club. But Miss Tina Farrell is quite persuasive, as we all know. And after the Divas and Diamonds event that made her governor of West Pasco Chamber, she coerced me into becoming a Rotarian at Port Richey. I believe the invitation was you need to be there Friday because you have to start up and become a Rotarian so that you can help me with the activities for the next Divas event. So I became a Port Richey Rotarian.
But that actually parlayed to even more. Her daughter now works with you, and she's an attorney
here
in the community, and she's actually going to follow Gil as president. And she was hired by your husband and Mike and works there as an attorney with them, right?
Absolutely. The best thing we ever did. Love that girl.
Yep.
But she is also a product of Interact.
Correct. Mm-hmm.
We have several young adults that came from Interact and came back to Port Richey. So I think that there's a correlation between helping the Interact students and grooming them to come back and to be full-time Rotarians.
Yeah. And again, I don't think Steve and Mike would have really looked at Anna to hire her if they hadn't already known her, because they knew her through Rotary, and the connection was just, it seemed to be almost seamless, that as soon as she passed the bar, it was done deal, and she just went right to work, which I think, again, just goes to Rotary is kind of like a family. Mm-hmm. Your support system. They're the first folks you go to when you have a challenge.
It actually becomes a family.
Yeah.
And you kind of live Rotary. After you're in it a while, it just kind of feels like this is the way it ought to be, and it's family.
Yep.
We would do anything for you guys, or anybody that's in our club. Not that we wouldn't do it out otherwise, but the Rotary family is everywhere.
Yep,
and
it
it's just amazing. I love
sure
it.
Sure is. Well, we're going to go to a commercial break. We're going to come back and talk to Gil and Wayne, because I think they both have some unique stories about how they became Rotarians. We'll be right back after this commercial break.
This is one bee that loves going to the dentist because it's made for you and me.
Providing a comfortable atmosphere in early dental care gives kids a great start for healthy teeth and gums for life.
Coming here, you're not just like an ordinary patient. You're actually like treated like a family member, and like you're treated like he actually gets to know you and makes you smile.
Welcome to New Tampa Pediatric Dental, and we are the
Bees!
Call New Tampa Pediatric Dental today.
Walk through life. Every day is a new beginning. Shine your light. It's a day and the world is waiting. Move along to the song singing in your soul. Feel the beat, clap your hands, let it take control. All you need, all you want, are you ready to fight?
It's an extraordinary organization of men and women who've made an investment in our community.
It's professions and peoples coming together, feeling friendship, and out of that, going out into the world doing good things.
There's just a feeling of being in a room with a lot of friends.
It's about how people communicate, people helping each other, how people grow together,
and how will people serve together?
Rotary for me served as a way not only to get involved with other people outside my business and my family, but also serves as a way to be able to start to give back to the community.
A kind word, just a kind gesture, just like 10 minutes of your time really changed somebody's life.
Rotary and community, it's like peanut butter and jelly. You know, they just go together real nicely.
It gives you joy. It gives you satisfaction. Most of the good things you do comes back to you several fold.
Rotary is able to reach the younger members and really continue to tell the story. And I think that's how we'll stay vibrant and valid for the next 20, 50, 100 years.
Welcome back. So we're talking about Rotary Minutes. That's what we call them in Rotary. Why did you join Rotary, and why do you stay as a Rotarian? So Wayne, how long have you been a Rotarian?
Since 2000.
Wow.
Wow, long time. Long enough.
And you joined Rotary because?
I joined Rotary because I worked, my career was a banker. And I worked with another banker, Ed Hancock, who's a member of the Holiday Club.
And I love Ed to death.
And
he's one of my best buddies.
You know, you ought to be in Rotary, and let me take you to a meeting. So he took me to a luncheon meeting and sold. And I've been in Rotary since 2000, and I can't imagine not being in Rotary now.
Yeah, and you spend half the year, we call you a halfback.
We're halfback, yep. We spend half of our year in the mountains of North Carolina, and the other half of our year spent here. And we spend all of our Rotary time here with the Rotary Club of Port Richey. And in North Carolina, we spend the other half of our Rotary year with the Rotary Club of Franklin, North Carolina.
With my good friend Frank.
That's right. So we are absolutely honorary members in Franklin and true members in Florida.
And we always, and you and Jenny are always at our extravaganza again, long-standing
yes,
worker bees
right.
up there in the front working the credit card machine and anything else we need done.
Right.
So you're always kind of all around, and you've served at the district level as well.
And I'm still serving at the district level as we speak as Paul Harris Society Chairman for the district, and been an AG and Assistant Governor like you.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't been the governor, don't have a desire for that.
It was a lot of fun.
It is a lot of fun, I'm sure, but just love the Rotary life.
Yeah, and why do you stay in Rotary?
It's where I belong. It's a situation where you like the people. I can't imagine missing Rotary meetings. And we travel around and go to different Rotary clubs wherever we are. So it's just a big family. And so why not?
Exactly.
Exactly.
Now, Gil, how long have you been a member of the Rotary Club of Port Richey?
About 3 years.
Wow. That's a pretty short line from club member to president. So
yes.
Why did you join Rotary?
Well, my wife's in Trinity Rotary, and she's been there about 5 years. And I used to go to a lot of their little social events and stuff like that. And one particular time, one of the AGs now, Perry Bean, was on a Honduras trip for Pure Rotary World. So we went down there, and I was in the back of a pickup truck in Honduras. And I told him that, you know what, when I get back, my office is right by where you guys meet for lunch. I said, I'll probably join your club. And I was doing a lot of Rotarian stuff, not being a Rotarian, you know, in the community. But when I got involved with Rotary, you know, you think it's like, you know, you don't have to do everything by yourself. And then you also don't have to do everything just in your club because it's international. A lot of people don't understand, but it's, you know, you can do move mountains with the amount of people that are in Rotary.
For sure.
And so I came back. So I actually was recruited in Honduras. So I was out of the country in
so
my own neighborhood.
If you realize there's kind of a theme here, Robin came from a service project, a fundraising project.
Yes.
So the club could raise funds. You've come from a service project.
Yeah.
Wayne came in to kind of grow his business, and he needed to to be in Rotary as a banker. And I think that everyone, you know, comes in for a different reason. But now the $10 million question is, why do you stay? Why do you stay in Rotary?
I have fun with it. I think it's very educational. I like the socialize. There's a lot of socialization. I go to other clubs too. And I get to meet and greet and do things in the community. And I feel like I'm participating, where years ago I was always just doing my job, doing my thing. And now I'm giving back. And, you know, it's very rewarding.
So. Very rewarding, yeah. Yeah.
Rewarding to me also. Even though we're retired, we're still members of Rotary,
right.
Even after business. So it's just a very rewarding, very family-oriented to me, and I just love it.
Robin?
Ditto with both of them,
yeah.
Although it's exciting. There's some, I've learned a lot. I've learned things that I had never been exposed to before. I enjoy the giving back, and I like to see this Rotary Club grow and do more so they can give back more to the local community.
Yeah, and you've done a lot of growing in the last few years. Your
yes.
club has almost doubled in size, I think.
It has doubled.
Yeah, and so you've done it. And I think, again, that goes to the kind of the dynamics of your club and how well you all, you know, kind of get along and how you all kind of, you know, are there to service the community, and I think it's a beautiful thing to see. Now, we've talked a little bit about the district. Gil mentioned some of the training, going to president-elect training, which we have coming up in Orlando. We bring all the presidents from all over the state of Florida, 8 districts, about 425 president-elects, and we train them all at once, which is much easier. I do have some friends that were governors that did their own pets individually in their districts, which is a lot of work, and it's certainly not as much fun. And both Wayne and Gil have been there. Robin hasn't had the pleasure just yet, but I'm sure she will. But I always think the greatest thing about pets is going to meet new people that you wouldn't normally see, and sharing how their club does whatever it is they do, because there's a different way to slice the onion, mm-hmm. and kind of hearing, you know, how they were able to overcome a challenge, but also the fact that they have the same challenges that we all have when it comes to trying to reach a goal or trying to grow a club, and how did they overcome it. I think to me that camaraderie is something that you just can't duplicate. And we've often talked about videotaping, just like we're videotaping now, and that would be missing from it. Plus you get to meet and see some great speakers. President-elect John Germ will be there for Rotary International, and plus lots of other dignitaries. My favorite, John Smarge, which is just a wonderful speaker. So that'll be a great time. And then next month in April, we all get to go have some fun on Royal Caribbean on the district cruise, which I don't know about you guys, but I'm really looking forward to unplugging, getting on a cruise ship, and just having some fun and fellowship. Who's going? Nobody's going? Really? Oh, you guys.
I think Anna's going.
Oh, I hope Anna's going. Well, yes. And I think that we're going to do a little service project in Cozumel when we get there. But the rest of it really is just about fellowship and fun, which there usually is no shortage. I think this is the 4th cruise we've done as a district.
Mm-hmm.
And I can tell you, as a governor, it's the easiest way to have your conference, because it's so much fun. You don't have to worry about packing any more fun into it. So we'll have a good time. And then in May, we've got 2 real important trainings. The district assembly, which is where anyone that's going to be a leader in your club, anyone that's going to serve on the board, that's their opportunity to come and learn their job. We'll be doing that hopefully down at the Clearwater campus of St. Pete College. And that's typically on the Saturday, and we'll start about 8:30 in the morning, kick off the classes at 9, and try to get everybody out of there by 3:30. So you all should be there. Wayne is usually there for sure. He's kind of a standard, but, you know, just because you're going to be done as president doesn't mean you stop learning. And then the next weekend is Rotary Leadership Institute, which I was telling Robin about, because that's a really great opportunity for new Rotarians to learn a little bit about everything in Rotary. You know, there's 3 parts to it. So the first part, the first day that you go, is really just a little bit about every piece of the pie of Rotary. And it's done in a discussion type of format. So, you know, as a discussion leader, we always say the answers are not here, they're there. And we look at the audience, because the answers are really in the room. Sure, there's statistical answers and there's dates and historical answers. But really the answers to the challenges that we face both in our businesses as well as in our clubs are really in the room. They're formulated through everybody that's in the room. So it's really a participatory type of thing. And there's, like I mentioned, there's three parts to that. So we encourage folks to try to do all three parts, and then you graduate, and then they have graduate courses. And those graduate courses focus on one subject for the entire day. So for instance, it might be the foundation. I mean, we focused on the foundation for the entire day. One time it was membership. So you're really able to delve into those things. A couple other things coming up in the district. Some other clubs having some fundraisers. The Rotary Club of Zephyr Hills is sponsoring the Founders Day 5K run. If you're interested in that and you're a runner, you want to go to www.foundersdayrace.com and register. They do have a 1 mile fun walk, so if running just isn't quite your thing, you can still go over and have some fun there. And that starts, I believe, at 8 o'clock in the morning and will be the shotgun start. Then on Thursday, March 10th, there'll be the Rotary Club of Crystal River is having their Beast Feast, which I think is very similar to the Wild Game Dinner. That they do. And the great thing about Citrus County is they all do things together. So I imagine you'll see all sorts of all the clubs there. That they are praising that they are going to have wild bison, alligator, bear, venison, elk, and more.
Ooh.
So that might be worth the while to go up there. And then, of course, on Saturday, March 12th, we have Rotary Goes to the Races, which Wayne and I think you've all been to that, where we go over to Tampa Bay Downs. The Tampa Bay Downs is able to dedicate a portion of the sales tax to a not-for-profit organization, which is Rotary's Camp Florida. And so we go over there and we have some hot dogs and hamburgers and some strawberry shortcake and watch the horses run. And this is a qualifier for the Kentucky Derby. So it's usually a pretty good race.
It's a lot of fun.
A lot of fun. I remember we wear our hats, our derby hats. A lot of us will have derby hats on. A lot of us will have baseball caps on, too. So now you don't have to have a derby hat on to come on over. And then Tarpon does a really fun thing on Saturday as well. They call it the annual Corks, Forks, and Craft Brew Party. Now, they do that at the Presbyterian Church on the Bayou, which is, those of you that know Tarpon Springs, real easy to find. And if you you want to go on their website or on the district website, and you can click on the calendar, and it'll take you right to Peggy Marie's email, and you can email her if you need any tickets or anything like that. It's $20 a person, so pretty inexpensive evening out. And I know it's a lot of fun in Tarpon Springs, so there's a lot of great things to see, and there's always a spectacular sunset. Which is great to see across the bayou. So that'll be kind of a fun thing to do there as well. I know for us here locally on March 12th, we have Raise the Roof for Pasco Rebuilds Together, which is being, as I mentioned, sponsored by the six Rotary Clubs in our area. And that fundraiser is an ask event. So anyone interested in joining a bunch of Rotarians, we're going to get together, have some dinner. We've got a cash bar and some entertainment as well. We're going to kind of talk a little bit about the rain event and some of the recovery efforts that already have occurred, and then some of those that still yet need to happen. We'll have Michelle Baker there. She'll kind of talk about the county's response, and then, of course, several of the leaders from Pasco Rebuilds Together will be there as well. It's at the Verizon Center, and if you want to need tickets for that, you can go just Google Raise the Roof. And you'll be able to find the Eventbrite ticket window there. Just click on it, and all you need to do is RSVP. I want to thank the three of you for coming on. You are the first club to be on the show, so congratulations.
Thank you.
It's always great to do the first one with a group of friends because we've known each other quite a long time. I want to say thank you to all of you for tuning in. We look forward to seeing you next week when we will highlight another Rotary Club here in District 6950. Until then, remember, my Rotary, doing good and having fun. Take care.